Hi, this is Ivan and welcome to the channel. Today I'd like to discuss one of the new features in the latest Microsoft Flight Simulator beta, which is the ability to memorize where your pop-out windows have been placed. Now this feature has been discussed before, but I wanted to put out a brief video on how this works with Air Manager 4, and also what does this mean for the application pop-out panel manager for Microsoft Flight Simulator. So what I want to do is I want to go ahead and switch to this view. And what we have here is the inside of the 172 with the G1000. And then these two bottom screens are my two external monitors that I typically run Air Manager on. And what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you how this works and where some of my experiences has been a little bit different than what's been put out so far. And I don't know if there's been an update that has changed how this new functionality works, but let's just take a look. So I have already set this up to some extent, so it's not going to be like a first-time process. But let's discuss, first of all, just popping these windows out to begin with. So you can see my cursor, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to press on the right Alt key, and you see that go from a pointy finger to a magnifying glass with the plus sign. Now I'm going to left click, and you can see on the bottom screen that that popped out. And normally, if you're doing this for the first time, it would pop out to here. And I'm going to click on that, and you notice it's on the other screen. I'm going to bring that over, and it would also pop out here if this were the first time, and it would be about this size. And right off the bat, there's something a little bit different here. And that is normally, under the old way, these two would be under one window and they would be connected. And then you would click on the little button and it would separate into multiple things. So now it automatically pops out as its own window. So that's elimination of a step, which is nice. And then what you would do is you would drag your pop out to your external displays and set them up. And so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to load up Air Manager. Let me move these out of the way. And I'm going to load up Air Manager. And let's go ahead and put this up and this up. And I'll minimize this. So here I have my bezels, and right now I have my screens, my external displays. I don't have backgrounds on them. These are just the normal Windows desktops, and I have the panel set for transparent. And what you would normally do is you would kind of size your window up. You would bring it, and with Air Manager, you would kind of tuck that white bar up under one corner and then bring this down. And then you would do the same thing for the other window, tuck it under there, and there you go. So now they're set up. Now, I'm speaking very specifically to Air Manager. For those of you who are using hardware bezels such as Real Sim Gear, I'm not sure how this process works because I don't know what you do with the white bar that goes across the top. And for Air Manager, it's easy. You just tuck it under something. Now, you can definitely make your panels be full screen or your pop-out panels be full screen. You always have that option, and it'll remember that. But for today's case, we're going to go with Air Manager. So now I have that, and it's all set up, and it's ready to go. So now I've ended my session. I'm going to close out, hit Escape, and let's say I'm going to go to the main menu. And the screens go away, and now you can just see the blank Air Manager panels with no pop-out windows behind them. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back into that. And we'll see what happens. Now, there has been, in previous videos put out, the sequence for exiting out of the plane. If you don't do it a certain way, you basically reset the windows and you would have to reset them up. My experience with this has not been exactly that, and I'll show you what I mean here in just a second. So here we are, we're back in the cockpit. The windows are up and it doesn't automatically pop out, which I believe is the how X-Plane works. I believe it would just automatically open up. Please correct me in the comments if I'm wrong on that. But for Microsoft Flight Simulator, at least as it stands now in the beta, you would go back and repop them out. And there you go. And boom. So they're good to go and you can fly your flight or your mission or whatever. And your windows, I mean, two clicks and you're good to go. Now, I'm going to close the air manager panels here. Hold on a second. I want you to be able to see just the pop-out windows. So these are the pop-out windows. And this white bar is the bar that I was saying I wasn't sure about if, you know, if you're using real sim gear or some other hardware bezel. So what's been put out is that to be careful not to close these windows first. But I'm going to do that, and let's watch what happens. And close the windows out, and I'm going to hit escape, and I'm going to go to back to the main menu. I'll go all the way out. All right, so now I've completely exited the plane. And I close the windows first, so I have to re-enter the plane. And let's see what happens. What's been reported is, if you close the windows out, the pop-out panel windows, prior to exiting the plane, it won't remember their locations. Let's see if that's still the case. So I'm going to hit Alt, and as you can see, it did remember. And in fact, if I were to put up my air manager panel, you can see that it's where it's supposed to be. And so that has changed. You can close out for the most part. This behavior is actually a little bit inconsistent. But you can, basically, it's going to remember where things are, wherever you move them, and then close out. So if I move this over to here, and then if I were to restart, let's see what happens. And you notice I moved that window on the left. I moved it to the left. And let's see what happens. So you can see it popped up. And I'll just go ahead and do this one just for reference. You can see this window that I moved over to the left. It did, in fact, come back that way. But here's something interesting. If I move this over to here, let me just make it drastic and shrink it down and then close it. And then I go back and let's restart. And back in the plane, watch what happens now. It doesn't remember that I moved it because I closed it prior. So basically, as near as I can tell, the current functionality is wherever this window is, when you exit out of the plane is where it's going to keep its location stored. So now if I were to do like I did before and shrink it down, make it kind of drastic so you can see, and now I hit restart, and go to open it. Now it's, so it, apparently the current behavior is wherever you leave the window in its position and size, wherever that is, when you exit the plane, if it's open, if that pop-out is open, that's where it will remember it. So if I were to close the, if I were to move this over to here, close it, and then restart the plane, it's still going to remember it as being down to the right. So that seems to be the current functionality. Let me show you a couple of other little quirks here. Let me reset this up. And I'm going to make it kind of obvious. So this I'm going to make small and bottom to the left. This I'm going to do the same thing. Make it small, bottom to the right. Okay. And I am going to exit out to the main menu. And this is a beta version. I've had a couple of crashed desktops. So this is my first beta, by the way. I've never been in Microsoft Flight Simulator beta before, but I was really interested in this particular feature because I do use pop-out panels so much. So I really wanted to see what the how this was being implemented and that kind of thing. Now, here's another thing to know about. So let's go up and change planes. And for example, we will use, let me see if I can find it. Here we go, the Diamond DA-62. We'll load that up and we'll go back to this airport. We'll hit fly. Now, what's interesting is this airplane uses the G1000 setup just like the Cessna 172 does. And let's watch what happens. So it's loading. Okay. And this is where there might be, so here I have, so it's the, there might be some issues here. So here we have basically G1000 and I'm going to pop these windows out. And as you can see, it put them in the same location that it did for the Cessna 172. So it's treating these G1000s. And it does the same thing for the Baron. If I were to load up the Baron, it would remember them in the same location, which for the most part is fine. For me, let me move these out of the way. I'm going to reload up Air Manager. For me, I use the same Air Manager cockpit layout for all the G1000 planes. And so once I set this up, tuck that under there. Good to go. This one's a little bit harder to do because it's black and it's hard to see those bars. But so let me tuck that under there. And that's pretty close. So for me, what you're seeing on the bottom two screens, that's what I do for all my G1000. I don't, G1000 aircraft, I don't have separate cockpits for all of them. You may have a different practice than that. So in other words, let's say for the Cessna, maybe you move over this. Let me pull this up here. Maybe you pull over this display. Bezel because you want to put some gauges here. Maybe you want to recreate some of the gauges or maybe a radio setup or flaps indicator, who knows. But for whatever reason, you are not, it's not the same. Your setup for the Diamond is different from the Cessna, is different from the Baron. Which is not unreasonable because the Diamond and the Baron are twins. So maybe you have other stuff going on. So as near as I can tell, that's a limitation that it's going to remember the location based off not the individual aircraft, but the avionics suite. So that's a problem. That could be a problem. And I mean, but your mileage is going to vary. It depends on what you do. So that'll be an issue. Now, what about the pop-out panel manager? So some of you have been using that app. I use it. And it's a wonderful app, and I've done a video on it, and it really did make life much more simple. But here's the rub. It is not compatible in my testing with this new functionality within Microsoft Flight Simulator. Now, I don't know if I've missed it and if there's a way to turn this functionality on or off with the settings. If there is, again, please put that in the comments below. But the way, bear with me here, the way that Pop-Out Panel Manager works is it's almost like it's just being a virtual you, clicking on stuff, moving stuff around, and that kind of thing. And the problem is, if you've moved, once it's moved and located the panels, then when you go in Microsoft and it goes to and run the panel manager, it will, through automation, click on the panel that it's trying to pop out, but it's going to pop out not to the main screen, which is the normal practice. Let me pull this up. So normally what would happen is you would, let me pull this up here. You would have Pop-Out Panel Manager, and you would start the pop-out process. And what would happen is it would pop the two windows out or pop the displays out, and they would be on this screen. And then once it popped everything out, it would then move them to their locations, their memorized locations. The issue now is when it starts the pop-out process, Microsoft Flight Simulator will automatically move the windows, the pop-outs, to their memorized location. It skips a step within Pop-Out Panel Manager. I know this is really confusing. And then it'll give you an error. Bottom line is, with my testing that I have done so far, I've not been able to make Pop-Out Panel Manager work with Microsoft Flight Simulator's new ability to memorize locations, which is a shame because the Pop-Out Panel Manager has some functionality that I really like. First of all, it's a per plane basis. So it can figure out what plane is loaded up, and it knows where to put stuff. So if you do have separate cockpits for the Baron versus the Cessna, it'll take that into account. The other thing that the Pop-Out Panel Manager does that I like is you can set it to where it will load with Microsoft Flight Simulator, and it will basically start the pop-out process once the plane is loaded and you hit the fly button. And so that automation is skipped. So just for those of you, including myself, who use this program, it doesn't work, not with this new functionality. So in any case, I think for Microsoft, it's a step in the right direction. I do like it. It works for me because I don't have multiple cockpits for various aircraft. And if I did, I would work them around the location of the G1000 panels. And so I could put my extraneous or different gauges around the G1000 bezels, and to where the bezels are always in the same place, and it's the other stuff that's different. So there's a workaround. It can be done. But I'm hoping that Microsoft will develop this feature even a little bit further. Like, for example, maybe it would just give you the option to maybe make it automatically pop out and not have to re-click, or perhaps give you a per plane memorization layout or the layout. I think that would be great. In any case, let me know what you think about this feature if you have any questions. Like I said, my experience has been different from others with can you close out the windows, what I've seen so far is that you can. It will remember them for the most part. But again, this is beta software. It's very early. Once this comes out in the full version, the non-beta version, the actual full release. I'll definitely run through it again and make sure that it's all the same. And if it's drastically different, I will certainly update this video. Otherwise, you guys have a great day, and I'll see you around.